Yo guys, what's up? I don't know if you guys watched my video from yesterday. Today I'm going to be switching out this frame with this frame. You guys might have already seen this frame. This was my frame. This was the frame of the bike in my first bike check video. It's obviously not black anymore. It's painted blue. But you guys are probably wondering if you guys have seen my video before this, which you guys should. There will be a little iCard right there, right now. I'm getting rid of this frame. It just got too small on me. I grew when I'm rolling out fakie and stuff. I, like, sometimes go over the bars, and it's just, it doesn't fit me anymore. It's too twitchy. It just doesn't fit me. So we're going to be putting on this 20.5 frame. This one's a 19.8 with 20-inch wheels. The chainstay is 13.25. This chainstay is 13, so it's a little bit shorter, might be a little bit more responsive. It's a little longer in the front, but I think it should work out well. So I'm actually going to be selling this frame on eBay or Craigslist. I'm just going to try to get rid of it. If any of you guys want it, you can DM me on Instagram. I don't know how much I'm going to sell it for, or if I'm even going to sell it, but I'm pretty sure I'm going to sell it. So yeah, before we start switching out the frames, I might not be done today, so this video might be like a two-day video, but it's all gonna be a one video. I'm not sure, I might finish. But we're gonna start off by wiping down the bike. Real crusty, and so are the pedals. Need to get some new bike parts soon. Okay, so I finally wiped down the bike, kind of, like, they're still dirty. It's not like super clean. I literally just spent maybe like 5 minutes trying to find, well, I found my ratchet, but I couldn't find any of my Allen keys, and I have no idea why, but they were in my school backpack. Probably why my backpack's been really heavy lately. Let's start taking off the parts. I think I'm gonna start off by taking off my back wheel. I really can't get that bolt off for some reason. At my house, I literally have all the tools I can think of in my garage. And my extension is not long enough for some reason. So I'm gonna go, well, I'll be right back. But I'm gonna go into the garage and find my extension. Okay, I already finally found my extension. Yes. But I think the chain's loose enough. Yeah, it's loose enough to take off. Okay, so we're just gonna, yeah, just pop off the back wheel. I'm gonna put it somewhere safe and. Oh, boys, this crusty. Oh, the bearings are so shot. Actually, maybe they just need to be tightened a little bit. But the threads are a little stripped. But as you guys can see, let me focus it a bit. Yeah, look how crusty that is. That is premium crust right there. I want to get a profile. But profiles are very expensive. Get the front wheel off. That was easy. I hope no, the floor doesn't get dirt. Oh, I just got wet, okay? I just got water all over me. Where did that even come from? It came from like the sea or something. So we got the top bolt out. I really need to get napkins. We're gonna get the headset off. My fork dropout is bent. Just realized that. I need like a shoe or something. Because my foot absolutely gets demolished every time I do this. Come on. It's always getting off that's hard. Putting it on is.
One eternity later.
It's nearly off. Man, I hate this stupid thing. I think it's because I painted it, and that's why it's so hard for it to come up. Oh.
Finally, we got it off.
Okay, so spacer.
Top cap.
Top cap. Little spacer thing. I don't know what it's called, but if I don't have it, it makes my thing wiggle everywhere. The race. And we have our bearings left now. So I'm just gonna just pop those off slightly. Don't want those going on the floor. Because my mom would absolutely kill me. I'm gonna try to aim it at my piece of paper. It's coming out. Oh, yeah. Trick shot right there, boys. Spot on. So I loosened the 6mm. Now I got my 8mm, I believe. Okay, that was way too easy. Perfect. There's our dust cover. Okay, so what I always do, I always get the end of my ratchet. Take off that thing right there. Actually, no, we'll just take it off. And we're just gonna smooth this over here. But what I always do is I always get this end of an extension. And then I get my ratchet. It's like, I never have a hammer on me, but, you know, just slide this thing in, right here, and just start heading away. Now it did. Okay, so let's see how crusty this thing is. Pretty crusty, but we're gonna clean it up and make it good as new. Holy crap, man. That one little bearing that I had left took me like 30 minutes. Just, it was seized. I greased it last time, but I mean, the water got in and just made it go all seized. And I had to get like a big hammer out of my garage and it was just hitting it for like 30 minutes straight. And I was like, man, I might not even be finished tonight. But somehow I got it out. I'll show you guys right now. My hands are like all greasy. They're more greasy in real life than they are on camera, but this stupid little thing, it like bonded with the paint or something. Okay, so I just washed my hands. They're still a little dirty, but whatever. And I totally forgot. I thought I would have to do the hammer and nail old trick with the chain to get it out. But I forgot I got this chain from Walmart. I switched from my coder chain to this like nice full link Walmart chain. I don't know. I really like this one. It's really light and it's been holding up. So yeah, I don't know. But I totally forgot there was a link on here. I really hope this chain's gonna fit the fit by co-frame, but if it doesn't, then we're just gonna have to proceed tomorrow. But I want to finish tonight. Don't you guys want to finish tonight? We want to finish tonight. But yeah, I'll try to get this little clip off.
Yeah, that's my boy.
I'm gonna try not to lose these pieces because I have a tendency of doing that.
Yeah, finally got the chain off. I already have my 6mm right here. Oh, doesn't take a 6mm. Takes a 5mm. Totally forgot. We totally disassembled the frame. And I'm gonna try to salvage this sticker.
Okay, and the last thing I'm gonna be doing today is just wiping down the bike, and I'm gonna try to salvage that sticker and put it on. As you can see, the pearl, like, I have a light over there, and it really shows the pearl. Kind of like a Gixxer blue. A little dark, though.
rip. It rip, no. No. Paint is like... I mean, the sticker smells like paint, but I think that's just from my frame. That's weird. Okay. So, we salvaged a lot of it, and I'm gonna try to somehow put it on the other bike. Yeah, we kind of... I'd say that's successful. What about you guys? You guys think that's pretty good? I think that looks sick.
Right there. Yeah, it covers up the whole scratch.
So, I think that's gonna wrap it up for today. Okay, guys, what's up? It is the next day. Last time I left off, I took off all the parts from the old frame. And finally, I have this frame just all bare. It's clean now. Got to save this pretty cool follow the leader sticker. And, yeah, today I'm gonna be finishing this thing up, putting back all the parts on, hopefully. Hopefully everything goes smoothly. And, then from there, hopefully we can go ride later. Yeah, we got the clip in. Yeah, this is gonna work? I don't know. I think it is. Yo. Now all I gotta do is just tie up the wheel and we should be good. Yo, the chain's a little tight, but I think we are good. I did this all in the morning too, which is crazy. This is sick. Yes. Oh, it feels so much better right away.
Saw a car crash, it reminded me of our first date. Then I went back, got massages at that one place. Always brought friends, but today I feel like doing this shit alone. My dad, when I wanna hear some wisdom, calling my cab, alcohol up in my system. So
as you guys can see, the bike looks so sick. Like, it is unreal. I did a couple 180s and stuff. It feels so much better. I did a manual, and the bike literally feels so good. Like, I'm so glad that I switched, because my older frame felt so sluggish. I thought it was just the parts, but no, literally the frame switched it all up. The shorter rear end makes it feel so much more responsive, and just the longer head tube makes bunny. I did a couple bunny hops. It feels way better because I have a little bit more time to pick it back up and then like push it out. It's just an overall great frame and just the bike is so sick. So yeah, I'm probably gonna do a riding video in a couple of days, but I think that's gonna be it for this one. If you guys liked it, please like, subscribe, and comment, and see you later. Peace out. Checking my statement till I got phone mail. Rushing all year like I commit roadkill. Killing everybody like I'm in a wrong deal. Do triple checks on every move I make. Work till I'm tired and sip on some latte. Only do shit if we do it my way. Everything gon' depend on what I say.